The Constitution of India, Preamble. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic and political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this Constitution.
Welcome back, my dear children. So how are you all? Let me start with a quote. You do not find the happy life, you make it. Happiness lies within you. It is not lying outside. How can you be happy, or how can you find out your happiness? By just loving whatever you do, isn't it? Now you are in 9th standard. You have some responsibilities, commitments. Wake up early. Get committed to your studies. Help out your parents. And love whatever you do. Automatically you will find your own happiness. Isn't it? Okay. Let's move to our new chapter. Chemistry has rendered a lot of contributions to mankind. Whatever metal is available on Earth's crust is subjected to chemical reactions and a new product is handed over to mankind. For the formation of new product, some basic components or compounds are required. They may be acids, alkalis or solutions. These acids, alkalis and solutions are mostly made up of non-metals. Non-metals may not have boisterous properties like metals. They may not be shiny, lustrous, malleable, ductile or hard. For example, sulfur. Sulfur is a very dull, soft metal. But the uses of sulfur to mankind is immense. So in this chapter we are going to study about non-metals and their diverse uses to mankind. Shall we move to the chapter? Look at the picture in your textbook. What all things can you see in that? Is it interesting to see the balloons flying up in the air? Which is the gas filled in these balloons? Children, can you tell me what gas is filled in these balloons? Hydrogen. You can note it down in the textbook. Which gas is mainly filled in cylinders used in hospitals for artificial respiration? Yes, oxygen. Note it down. Which is the gas filled in tires to increase their efficiency? Usually nitrogen. Please note it down. So, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen. These are some of the non-metals we are already familiar, isn't it? So, non-metals are usually liquids or gases, okay? Children, let me introduce you to the components of air. Do you know what are the components of air? Look at this table in the textbook and the chart also, pie chart. So you can see nitrogen is present, 78.8% of nitrogen is there in air. 20.95% of oxygen is there in air and 0.9% of argon and 0.038% of carbon dioxide and 0.032 other gases are there. So which is the most abundant gas here? Nitrogen. Nitrogen is the most abundant gas in atmosphere. So what are the elements present in food materials? Carbohydrate. All the food materials we have contains carbohydrates protein, fat, isn't it? So what does carbohydrate contain? Carbohydrate contains elements like carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. And what does protein contain? Carbon, hydrogen, oxygen and nitrogen. So what does fat contain? Carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. Likewise, what are the other things we use in our day-to-day life? Most of the substances we use for our house purpose or house construction is made up of PVC or polythene, isn't it? So what is PVC made up of? PVC is made up of carbon, hydrogen and chlorine, whereas polythene is made up of carbon and hydrogen. So carbon, hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, chlorine, these are the non-metals, some of the non-metals which are very useful for all sorts of life activities. Not only life activities, they are used in industrial field also. Children, we will move to the first non-metal, that is hydrogen. What are the uses of hydrogen? How is hydrogen formed? All these we will have a detailed analysis. Okay. Hydrogen is a non-metal which was discovered by a scientist called Henry Cavendish. He named it as inflammable air. The name hydrogen is derived from the word hydrogens, which means that produces water. Something which produces water. Okay. So hydrogen is a gas which is mainly seen in sun and stars. It is present in a large amount in biosubstances. Many compounds are formed using this element hydrogen. Can you name some compounds? Water. What is the chemical formula of water? H2O. So note it down in the textbook. H2O. What are other compounds made up of hydrogen? Yes. Sulfuric acid, H2SO4. Hydrochloric acid, HCl. What else? Methane, CH4. So these are some of the compounds which use hydrogen. Okay. Now, children, let's move to the preparation of hydrogen. How do you prepare hydrogen in an laboratory? Let's take 5 ml of dilute hydrochloric acid and add zinc granules to it. Shall we write the reaction? So what has happened here? Dilute HCl, to dilute HCl we are adding zinc granules. So what is the chemical reaction? What are the products formed here? Shall we note it down? So the equation is balanced. 2HCl plus zinc gives ZnCl2 plus hydrogen formation is happening here. So how can you identify hydrogen is a gas? How will you identify whether hydrogen gas has been formed or not? There is a way to easily identify the formation of hydrogen gas. So what is that way? You bring a matchstick near to the test tube in which this reaction happens. So what happens? You can hear a pop sound. So what is happening there? When you hear a pop sound, it shows that hydrogen gas has been formed there. So this is the reaction here. Now if you observe the reaction here, what is happening? What happens in hydrogen chloride? Hydrogen is replaced by zinc. Isn't it? So here, hydrogen is displaced and zinc is substituting here. And hydrogen is given out separately. So in this reaction, in this chemical reaction, hydrogen is being displaced by zinc. Okay, so what sort of reaction is this? It is called displacement reaction or substitution reaction. So what do we call such reactions? Such reactions are called displacement or substitution reactions. So we call such reactions as displacement or substitution reactions. So where did we start? We started with the preparation of hydrogen in laboratory. What did we do? We took dilute HCl and added zinc granules to it. The products were ZnCl2 and hydrogen gas. How will you identify hydrogen gas? By bringing a burning matchstick to the test tube, to the end of the test tube, to the neck of the test tube. So what happens? You can hear a pop sound. If a pop sound is heard, it shows the presence of hydrogen. So when we write the chemical reaction, it comes like this. 2HCl plus zinc gives ZnCl2 plus H2. So what is happening here? Hydrogen is being displaced or substituted by zinc. So such reactions we call it as displacement reaction or substitution reaction. So this is how hydrogen is prepared in laboratory. So children, all the reaction between metals and dilute hydrochloric acids are all examples for displacement and substitution reactions. All the reactions between metals and dilute hydrochloric acids are called as substitution or displacement reactions. Shall we see more examples for that? Just look into the textbook. You can see Mg is magnesium, it's a metal. It reacts with hydrochloric acid. Mg plus 2HCl gives MgCl2 plus H2. Look at the second reaction. Zn, zinc, plus H2SO4, that is also an acid, sulfuric acid, gives ZnSO4 plus H2. Mg plus 2HNO3, nitric acid, magnesium, it's a metal. MgNO3 twice plus H2. So these are all examples for substitution reaction or displacement reactions. Some more examples are given for displacement reaction. Zn plus CuSO4 gives ZnCuSO4 plus Cu, isn't it? So here Cu, that is copper, is being displaced by zinc. So it is also a displacement reaction. 2NaBr plus Cl2 gives 2NaCl plus Br2. Here Br, that is bromine, is being displaced by chlorine. It is substituted for chlorine. So that is also a displacement or substitution reaction. CH4 plus Cl2 gives CH3Cl plus HCl. So here CH4, 4 hydrogen atoms are there, isn't it? So there one hydrogen is removed or displaced, substituted for one chlorine atom. So we get the product is CH3Cl plus HCl. So all these reactions are examples for displacement as well as substitution reactions. Now we have seen some examples for displacement and substitution reactions. Now we will move into our core topic, that is hydrogen. What are the important reactions of hydrogen? Shall we discuss one by one? Children, let's see the first reaction of hydrogen, which is very important reaction. That is a reaction between hydrogen and oxygen. Hydrogen burns in oxygen to give out water, and lot of heat is released during this reaction. What do we call such a reaction which releases heat? We call it as exothermic reaction, which we have studied in 8th standard, isn't it? So this is a highly exothermic reaction. Why do we call it as exothermic? Because heat is being released here. So here you can see hydrogen and oxygen combined together, two different substances combined together to form a new product. So such reactions are also called as combination reactions. So it is also called as combination reaction. So this is the first important reaction of hydrogen. What is it? Reaction between hydrogen and oxygen. So here water is formed, it's an exothermic reaction, moreover it is a combination reaction. Okay, now we move to the next important reaction of hydrogen. Children, the next important reaction of hydrogen is reaction between hydrogen and chlorine. Reaction of hydrogen with chlorine. So how does that happen? Hydrogen reacts with chlorine in presence of sunlight to give hydrochloric gas, 2HCl. So the equation is balanced here. So now observe this reaction very carefully. Isn't it a combination reaction? So this is also a combination reaction.
reaction.
So children, we have discussed two important reactions of hydrogen. Reaction of hydrogen with oxygen and chlorine. Both are combination reactions also. Shall we see more examples for combination reactions? Yes, it is given in your textbook. You will analyze that. See, more examples for combination reactions are N2 plus 3H2 gives 2NH3. So it's a combination reaction. Magnesium and oxygen combine together to give 2MgO, magnesium oxide. That is also a combination reaction. Hydrogen plus sulfur gives H2S, hydrogen sulfide. So it's a combination reaction. 2Na plus H2 gives 2NaH, that is sodium hydride. So that is also a combination reaction. CaO plus H2O gives CaOH twice, calcium hydroxide, which is a combination reaction. So now we will analyze what are the uses of hydrogen. Okay, so some of the uses they are given here: for the industrial production of ammonia and methanol, to saturate unsaturated oils as a fuel. So hydrogen is used as a fuel. We are going to have a detailed study about that. Okay, what else? What are the uses of other uses of hydrogen? It is used to fill balloons, isn't it? So that you can write it down in the textbook itself. To fill balloons. Okay, now how is hydrogen used as a fuel? Why is it used as a fuel? As for that, we will have to see the graph, bar graph, which is given in the textbook. Shall we analyze that? Look at the bar graph. The first one is 143 kilojoules, isn't it? The x-axis is mentioned as fuels and the y-axis is mentioned as energy produced by burning in kilojoules per gram. Okay, the first fuel is hydrogen and it gives out 143 kilojoules per gram. The second fuel is methane. It gives out 56 kilojoules per gram. Third one is petrol, 48 kilojoules. Coal. Coal is another fuel which gives out 39 kilojoules. Ethanol, 30 kilojoules. Methanol, 23 kilojoules. Carbohydrates, that is 16 kilojoules. And carbon monoxide gives out 10 kilojoules. Isn't it? So, now looking at the bar graph, what did you understand, children? So, you can see that it is clear that hydrogen gives out the maximum amount of energy when burned. So what is actually happening while running a vehicle? When you start a vehicle, the fuel inside the vehicle is burning and this energy helps the vehicle to move at a very high speed. And if this burning, that is the energy given out by burning, is higher, the vehicle goes more fastly, isn't it? So you can see from the bar graph that hydrogen gives out the maximum energy, that is 143 kilojoules per gram. So hydrogen is the best fuel when compared to petrol or diesel. But we don't use hydrogen as a fuel. Do you use hydrogen as a fuel in your cars and bikes? No. So why don't we use hydrogen as a fuel? Because it has got its own merits and demerits. So shall we analyze what are the merits and demerits? Merits, we already know. It gives out the highest calorie or calorific value. What do we call it as? The energy given out is called as calorific value. So hydrogen gives out the highest calorific value when compared to other fuel. That is the most important merit. The second merit is it doesn't create any sort of pollution when compared to petrol and diesel. So that is also very good, right? And the third important merit is when compared to other fuels like petrol and diesel, Hydrogen is available in plenty in Earth's atmosphere or as compounds when compared to other fuels. But even then, we never use hydrogen as a fuel. Why is it? So now we shall discuss the demerits of using hydrogen as a fuel. So there are limitations to use hydrogen as a fuel. The first thing is, because of its high calorific value, hydrogen burns with an explosion. You would have often heard of hydrogen bombs, right? So whenever hydrogen burns, it burns with a bang, that is explosion. So it is dangerous to use hydrogen as a fuel. And the second important demerit is, it is very difficult to store hydrogen. Where will you store hydrogen? It is highly risky to store hydrogen in a cylinder. There are possibilities for the cylinder to burst out and explode. So how will you store this hydrogen? And in case you store, how will you transport this? A small amount of sunlight is enough for hydrogen to burst out. So storage and transportation of hydrogen gas becomes very difficult. So these are the two important limitations. Number one, hydrogen burns with an explosion. Number two, storage and transportation of hydrogen is very, very difficult. In case we overcome these limitations, hydrogen becomes an excellent fuel for replacing our fossil fuels like petrol and diesel and reducing the environmental pollution. Hope very soon we will overcome all these limitations and we will get a good fuel, isn't it? So children, today's class I'm going to wind up. We will discuss the other non-metals in the coming classes. Bye. Take care.